Ferdinand von Wrangel. Ferdinand Friedrich Georg Ludwig Freiherr von Wrangel, Russian, TR. Ferdinand Petrovich Wrangel, January 9, 1797, 6 June 1870, was a Baltic German explorer and seaman in the Imperial Russian Navy, honorable member of the St. Petersburg Academy of Sciences, a founder of the Russian Geographic Society. He is best known as chief manager of the Russian-American Company, in fact governor of the Russian settlements in present-day Alaska. In English texts, Wrangel is sometimes spelled Wrangel, a transliteration from Russian, which more closely represents its pronunciation in German, or Wrangel. Biography. Wrangel was born in Pskov, into the noble Baltic German Wrangel family and was a distant nephew of General Feldmarschall Friedrich von Wrangel. He graduated from the Naval Cadets College in 1815. He participated in Vasily Golovnin's world cruise on the ship Kamchatka in 1817-1819. Kalmykia Expedition. He was appointed in 1820 to command the Kalmykia Expedition to explore the Russian polar seas. Sailing from St. Petersburg, he arrived at Nizhny Kalmyk on November 2, 1820, and early in 1821 journeyed to Cape Shelegsky on sledges drawn by dogs. He sailed afterward up Kalmar River, advancing about 125 miles into the interior, through territory inhabited by the Yakuts. On March 10, 1822, he resumed his journey northward, and traveled 46 days on the ice, reaching 72 degrees 2 north latitude. He left Nizhny Kalmyk on November 1, 1823, and returned to St. Petersburg on August 15, 1824. He established that north of the Kalmar River in Cape Shelegsky there was an open sea, not dry land, as people thought. Together with Fyodor Matyushkin and P. Kuzmin, Wrangel described the Siberian coastline from the Indigirka River to the Kalyachinskaya Bay in the Chukchi Sea. See Northeast Passage. His expedition made a valuable research in glaciology, geomagnetics, and climatology and also collected data about natural resources and native population of that remote area. Kroetke World Voyage. Having been promoted to commander, Wrangel led the Russian world voyage on the ship Kroetke in 1825-1827. Governor of Russian Alaska. He was appointed chief manager of the Russian-American Company in 1829, effectively governor of its settlements in North America, present-day Alaska. Wrangel was the first of a series of bachelor appointees to the office of governor who had to find a wife before assuming the duties in America, the Russian-American Company rules having been changed in 1829. Prior to his departure for Russia's American colonies, he was married to Elizabeth Theodora Natalie Caroline de Rosillon, daughter of Baron Wilhelm de Rosillon. He traveled to his post early in 1829, by way of Siberia and Kamchatka. After thoroughly reforming the administration, he introduced the cultivation of the potato, opened and regulated the working of several mines, and urged upon the home government the organization of a fur company. He promoted investment, and sent out missionaries. He began a survey of the country, opened roads, built bridges and government buildings. He made geographical and ethnographical observations, which he embodied in a memoir to the Navy Department. Recalled in 1834, he returned by way of the Isthmus of Panama in the United States, where he visited several cities. Admiral. Wrangel was promoted to Rear Admiral in 1837, and made Director of the Ship Timber Department in the Navy Office, which he held for 12 years. He became Vice Admiral in 1847, but resigned in 1849, and temporarily severed his connection with the Navy to assume the presidency of the newly reorganized Russian-American Company. Wrangel had been a member of the Board of Directors of the Russian-American Company from 1840 to 1849. In 1854 he re-entered active service and was made Chief Director of the Hydrographical Department of the Navy. He was the Minister of the Navy 1855 to 1857. Retirement and death. Wrangel retired in 1864. He opposed the sale of Alaska to the United States in 1867. Wrangel wrote the book Journey Along the Northern Coastline of Siberia and the Arctic Ocean and other books about the peoples of Northwestern America. He lived in his last years in rural in the eastern part of Estonia. He had bought the manor in 1840. He died in Dorpat, Livonia. Writings and account of the physical observations during his first journey was published in German, Berlin, 1827, and also in German extracts from Wrangel's journals, Reiselings der Nordküste von Sibirien und auf dem Eismeer in den Jahren 1820-1824, 2 volumes, Berlin, 1839, which was translated into English as Wrangel's Expedition to the Polar Sea, 2 volumes, London, 1840. The complete report of the expedition appeared as Otzes Chui dus Juren im Bergamseberi, Pol d'Auetamor, 2 volumes, St. Petersburg, 1841, and was translated into French with notes by Prince Galitzin, under the title Voyage sur les côtes septentrionales de la Sibérie et de la mer glaciale, 2 volumes, 1841. From the French version of the complete report, an English one was made under the title A Journey on the Northern Coast of Siberia and the ICC, 2 volumes, London, 1841. The book influenced Charles Darwin's thinking on animal navigation, leading him to propose that humans and animals possess an innate ability for dead reckoning. Darwin wrote, Wrangel also published, List of places named after Wrangel.